So today we have some sad news, in fact a lot of sad news. So let's get into it, starting off with a little bit of good news, starting off with the 48th section. If you're not familiar with the format of this show, it is a weekly show talking about the news of AKB48 as well as the sister groups and rival groups, Nogizaka and Kiyakizaka. You can always see what section you are on the top right of the screen. Now, let's start off with AKB48. So first of all, Sousenkyou. As we all know, that's the yearly event where we all vote for our members that we want to be ranked higher. And this year, Sousenkyou will be June 16th. Now, although we don't have a venue yet, we do have a date. So if you were thinking about a venue to submit, now you can actually know a date and then tell potential venue people when would be the best time. So now that we have a date, maybe we'll get closer to seeing which venue could be picked. Maybe they'll have like a series of 10 venues and then fans will be able to vote out of each of them. That might be a good decision. And next is news that some people think is bad and some people think is good. And that's with Sakamichi AKB being once again in AKB's single. This time it is for the 51st single and it will be in Type E. We don't know the lineup just yet. It won't be the same since some of the members aren't there anymore. Like Ito Marika, who isn't in Nogizaka anymore. So maybe they'll change it up a little. I'm just curious to see what happens. And if Takahiro does the dance setup again, then that'll be really cool. Personally, that's what I wish for. I just want Takahiro to be in charge of dancing, and I feel like it'll turn out good. And next up is Stu48 with some of their first day sales numbers. They have sold 160,980 copies. That's a lot of copies. So super glad for Stu. That song is pretty good, so go ahead and listen to it. It has sort of like the Sony vibe that Sakamichi has. So if you sort of like that vibe, then go ahead and take a listen to that. If not, you can go ahead and listen to it since it is a 48 group. And you can go ahead and see how you like it. But speaking of Stu48, actually the documentary will be in the cinema, you know, instead of having to collect all of the DVDs, you can actually go and watch it in a theater. Now, this is going to happen soon. It's going to happen February 8th. So if you are in Japan, like right now, or in the next couple of days, then maybe you can go and see it. It'll be in Odaiba at United Cinemas Aqua City, so you can go ahead and watch that. And next up is with Team 8 that actually joined Twitter. They had joined Instagram previously, but now they're now on Twitter. You can go ahead and see the link down below to see which members are there. And I imagine a lot of them will start coming out soon with different accounts. And now I'm going to individual members. I want to start off on the low notes, that way we could build up again until we get to the Nogizaka section, which we get teared down again. Now, this is about Tanaka Yuka, who's actually going to graduate from HKT48. Now, it's been around 6 years since this member has been here, and she says that she wants to move on and continue with her studies, which a lot of members have been saying recently. Her graduation live will happen on February 27th, so that's pretty soon, this month in fact. So if you're a fan of hers, go ahead and check out her graduation live. And speaking of members that are going to graduate, we're going to talk about Fresh Lemon and Fuu-chan. Miori is going to have two graduation concerts. One of them is kind of like a live and the other one's like a proper concert. Both of them have concert dates right back to back on April 3rd and 4th. They will be in Osaka at the Oryx Theater, and Fresh Lemon will have a future one in her home city. This will be in Olympic Sonic City in Saitama on April 16th. So, I mean, if you're available for any of those days, go ahead and try to get tickets to that. If it's not too late for that, I imagine. And next up, something pretty cool. Actually, one of the members became an editor-in-chief of a web magazine. This is Murase Sae, who is now the editor-in-chief of Light Up. And you can go ahead and check out the website down below to see all the different information there is. There's a little icon that says 1 week equals 7 days. I mean, that tells you it's super informative already, and it's about fashion mostly. So go ahead and check it out. And last bit, which is the news I'm most excited about. It is about a new photobook coming out with Kato, Rena. Yes, about time for her to finally get one. Now we need those other members that have been needing one for a while now. Me too. But with this coming out March 28th, I am thinking about picking it up. I think I am going to pick it up, in fact, and I will do a critique on it. This has been shot in different locations around the world, too. One of them is Hawaii, and the other one, I think, is London. Don't quote me on that. I think it's Hawaii and London. So it seems like this definitely has potential. And now we're gonna go on to the graduating members, starting off with Wasamin releasing a new music video. This is for her upcoming single, and the music video is called Sado no Ondekoza. go ahead and look for that down below. If you like her style of music, then I really recommend checking it out. And next up is Maeda Atsuko, who's going to be in a new movie. Now again, looking at the pictures of the whole relationship chart that's for this movie, it doesn't seem like she's going to be a main character. It seems like she might be a support character in this. But this is about 8 different women living different lives. And from the sounds of it, it sounds like it's a little bit more about the food, because they seem to highlight that a lot, especially with the title of the actual movie. It is Taberu Onna, which is kind of like Taberu is eat, and then Onna would be like woman. But the description says this is about gourmet and sex. So if you're interested in that, you can go ahead and watch it in September of this year. And that does it all for the graduated section. Let's go to the 46, where there's some interesting news. First of all, I want to start off positive with Nogizaka finally releasing stuff on Spotify. Well, in America, I imagine other parts of the world already have this. But in America and some of the other countries, you can now listen to the Under album. That's the only thing they have available right now, so go ahead and take a listen to that to show interest that you want to hear more from Nogizaka on Spotify. Highly recommended you do that. And then maybe we'll get Kiyakizaka on there too. But of course, the Under album isn't my favorite pieces of music from them, so I'm a little disappointed, but I'm super happy that they took the first step already. And speaking of the first step, they took another step with having on the website support for different languages. Of course, it is machine translated. It isn't like someone sitting down and then like retranslating everything into different languages. It's actually at the bottom right of the screen. You can see where you can translate it, and it's pretty nifty. It's a little bit better than Google Translate, although it does get some things wrong, like on the official notification that this supports it now. Like, they got Nogizaka wrong. Like, they put with an S instead of a Z. So it has a couple bugs in there, but hopefully they'll like input like, if it's this word, it's exactly this, or something along those realms. But the languages that are now supported are English, simplified and traditional Chinese, Korean, Indonesian, Malay, and Thai. So go ahead and check it out and try it for yourself. And there was even another step from Nogizaka, starting off with the continuation of their Vivo channel. Now, if you remember, like 2 years ago, they uploaded videos. They uploaded like 2 videos. It was like Seifuku Mannequin and probably like Guru Guru Curtain or something, I can't remember. But now they have actually uploaded a lot of A-sides to their singles. So go ahead and go on that Vivo channel and go leave comments how much you appreciate them starting off. And hopefully from here on out, we can see more support from them, which seems like they've taken the first steps to actually do it worldwide instead of limited areas. So super cool to see that for sure. And link for that Vivo channel will be down below. Next up, let's talk about Kiyakizaka for a little bit, starting off with the announcement that their new single is going to come out soon, and that's pretty much all that we know. That single comes out the 7th of March, so a month away. They'll probably announce the Senbatsu lineup soon, just so we get prepared. I'm guessing it's going to be Tetchy again, although I don't want it to be Tetchy. I want it to be Neru or Zoomin or even Yuipon. They still want to keep that little bit edgy just to contrast with Hiragana, which I'll mention a little bit later. So I feel like we might see Tetchy again, although I am hoping for a different one. Hey, we might even see Suzumoto be the center or something. So Hiragana Kiaki is going to release their first album, kind of like the Unders from Nogizaka released their first album, except this one is to kind of disconnect what I imagine from Kanji. With this, we'll be able to see, okay, this is their set of music, and here's Kanji's set of music, even though Hiragana Budokon did a lot of Kanji songs and even Nogizaka songs. It's kind of weird to see them starting to separate them. I think they would be way stronger having them together as one and kind of having it like the Unders and Nogizaka. But if you want to know more information about that and my opinion further detailed, as well as other people's opinion, you can go ahead and check out the Slope podcast to see exactly what we think about it and why this is generally not the best idea. And next up, let's get into a little bit more sad news. I'll go in order that it was announced. First of all, Ikoma Arena has actually announced a graduation. People saying Shirashima is going to graduate soon. Didn't expect Ikoma Arena to do it first. Ikoma Arena says that she will actually go on forward. She'll keep working as a talent as we've seen her skill set to be. And she will want to be a contributor to society and be able to make lots of friends after she graduates. So this single is going to be her last single. So there's no set date, but I imagine when the 21st single is probably like about to release, she'll be gone by then. But she's not the only one who announced graduation in Nogizaka. Actually, Roti announce her graduation, and it's actually happened very, very soon. It's actually going to happen at the end of March. So this is kind of like, oh hey, you're gonna graduate, but I'm gonna graduate first. Maybe this was a deal of like, Roti told management first, and then Ikuma happened to come first in line for some reason, and Roti's like, hey, what about me? So then they brought her in further in line, and I don't know exactly how it went, but having these in the same week is really painful, and especially since Nogizaka has such few members, it actually does take more of a blow. I mean, everyone who graduates is really sad, but I feel like it's a little bit more concentrated with so little members. Roti says this will be a brand new beginning for her, and I'm excited to see what she could do, because with her singing voice, I feel like there's a lot of things she could do. Hopefully she becomes a solo artist and does great things. And that actually does it all for the news this week. Again, sad for those graduations that happened, but hopefully they move on to better things. That's why I don't like to linger on the sad parts of it, because I know there's happier things going forward for them. So go ahead and leave a like, subscribe, comment down below about your thoughts about all the recent graduations and even the Sakamichi AKB and all the different stuff that's happening. Go ahead and leave those comments and share with your friends this video so they can keep up with the news. So, as I say every single week, thank you all for watching.